Hello, I'm Deena. Today we're visiting Textron Aviation, a designer and manufacturer of aircraft and aviation products. Textron Aviation's world headquarters is in Wichita, Kansas, and the company has offices and service centers around the world. Textron Aviation has been inspiring the journey of flight for over 90 years and builds Beechcraft and Cessna aircraft. Today, we're going to learn about how robotics and automation are used in the aviation industry. Let's go! I'd like to introduce all of you to Stacy, an automation engineer here at Textron Aviation. Stacy, can you tell us what an automation engineer does exactly?
My job is to use automation and robotics to make building airplanes safer and easier for people to do. In the past, building airplanes took a lot of repetition and physical labor from a lot of people. Today, we use robots and automation to do some of that repetitive work safer, faster, and more precisely.
How do you figure out how your robots work?
Usually, our team's tasked with solving one of three problems using automation and robotics: the safety, quality, and ergonomic issues. Ergonomics is making the workplace a more comfortable place to work for the employees. Usually our team gets together and we brainstorm how we can use automation and robotics to build a process or a machine to help fix these problems.
Once we believe that we've got a solution, our team runs computer simulations to see if it works. Testing our solution digitally saves us a lot of money and time. It also keeps us from slowing down production for other workers. I spend about 70% of my time looking for solutions and testing them on a computer, and another 30% of my time fixing problems and maintaining the robots.
Now let me ask you something, Deena. Do you like playing video games, doing computer work, or building things?
Yeah, definitely.
Then you've already got some of the skill sets needed to do this job.
Is that how you learn to become an automation engineer?
That's one of the ways for sure. When I was going to high school, I attended woodworking classes, shop classes, and welding classes that I still use those skill sets today. So at an early age, I was doing hands-on skills and building things. I joined Textron Aviation as an experimental test mechanic when I had 2 years left of college at Wichita State.
I wanted a job that was very hands-on. I knew I was interested in some sort of engineering field, but I also wanted to make sure my job would actually let me build things. I earned a degree in engineering technology with a focus on mechatronics, which combines mechanical and electrical engineering.
After I graduated, I joined the automation team as an automation and robotics engineer. I'm still working there to this day, and I absolutely love it.
What do you like about your work?
I enjoy how hands-on it is. On a daily basis, I get to design processes and machines that utilize different types of engineering, such as mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and computer engineering.
That's really cool. Okay, I have one more really important question for you.
What's that?
Can you show me how the robots work?
Absolutely.
Okay, that was super fun. It would be so cool to do work like this every day. How can I get started while I'm still in school?
I'd recommend taking as many science, technology, and math classes as possible. I'd also recommend taking shop classes so you have a better understanding of machinery and how it works, like all engineers should.
I can do that. I think my high school has a robotics club. Would that be good to join?
Absolutely. Any firsthand knowledge that you can get beforehand is definitely gonna be a plus for you. There's another way that you can get some firsthand experience here.
What's that?
Textron Aviation provides a paid summer internship for high school students. This means you get to come in and help with real projects and work alongside people doing this work. It gives you a chance to experience what it's like to work here and try your hand at some of the jobs we do here. And after you graduate, we even have paid internships for college students that will teach you great skills you need to get started in robotics.
Okay, that sounds amazing. And you get paid for it? Yeah. I'm in. Is there anything else I can do to start preparing to work in this field someday?
Yes, you can work on your soft skills. Soft skills are traits like being on time to work and being a good team player. Also, some people are afraid of failure, but failure is something we embrace as engineers. Whenever we have an opportunity to fail, we can assess what we're doing and build a better product.
So in this job, failing can be a good thing?
Absolutely. Failure is part of inventing new things. If the Wright brothers would have stopped every time they didn't get their ideas off the ground, we'd have never had airplanes in the first place.
I'd like to thank Stacy and everyone here at Textron Aviation for showing me around this amazing facility and teaching me about robotics and automation in manufacturing airplanes. I learned a lot today, and I hope you did too. Until next time, this is Deena signing off in Wichita for Cool Careers. Have a great day.